Well, God bless you, Cooper City Church of God, and an entire body of Christ. My name is Darren. This is my beautiful wife, Celina, and we're the prayer pastors here at Cooper City Church of God. And we just thank God for you joining us on this journey of 21 days of prayer.
Yes.
We also encourage that each and every one of you step out in your spiritual growth and go on this fast journey with us in addition. So during these 21 days of prayer, our pastor gave us a theme in January about moving forward. And that's moving people towards Christ, towards community, as well as towards their calling. And we're encouraging each and every one of you during these 21 days of prayer to move towards those particular areas. This week, we're starting off with moving people towards Christ. And we're going to have a scripture and an explanation behind that with my beautiful wife.
We're coming from Matthew 27, and we're just starting off at verse 31 and 32, and it says, "And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. Him they compelled to bear his cross." It's important, people of God, as we move people towards Christ, that we understand what this passage is saying. Even our Lord needed help in carrying the weight of the cross. And so likewise, we ought to help others bear their cross. Because Jesus even said to his disciples, "Unless you carry your cross and deny yourself and follow me, you are not my disciples." And so this is important to us. So we want to pray that we do exactly what the word tells us to do. Let us pray. Father, we just thank you. We thank you, Lord, for the sacrifice. We thank you, Lord, that that example of the word reminds us that we ought to help others carry their burdens. So, Father, I thank you, Lord, for touching our hearts, making us sensitive to the pain that people are experiencing, oh God. And Father, our plight is to move people towards you. You've called us to the ministry of reconciliation, and we accept the charge. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. So in addition to our 21 days of prayer journey, we're going to be at the church Monday through Friday, and we're going to be at a 5 a.m. prayer.
So yes, we're just asking 5 a.m. the body, prayer.
And we're asking the entire body of Christ, the body, to come out and join us. Bring your young ones out there. It's a beautiful opportunity to get deeper and closer with God. Yeah. We also, as I stated before, we'd be fasting, so we will have fasting material at the table in Connection Central. And so there will be material there. Also, our Wednesdays will be back, our noonday prayer, as well as our Wednesday night teaching and prayer service. And on the last Wednesday of August, we're going to set it up, and we call in the service anonymous. So during the entire 21 days of prayer, we're just asking you that take a prayer card, distribute it to families and friends, as well as yourself. Just write down your prayer request, because on that particular fourth Wednesday, we're going to come into a service of just tarrying. We're going to be praying for the prayer requests. We're coming corporately to just to pray and just and believe God for breakthroughs and miracles to happen in a time of not only prayer but also fasting. So check out our videos on every day for the next 21 days. Continue to encourage one another, move people towards Christ, their community, and their calling. God loves you. We love you. If you don't have a church home, Cooper City is the right place for you. God bless you, and have an awesome 21 days.